Now, the Maestrian thesis is a maybe a rather bizarre one, that all of life is this gigantic sacrificial process. But it's not one that flies in the face of the facts. And one might say that various aspects of contemporary culture, with a particular kind of utopianism, is far more remote from the egregious cruelties and brutalities that are evident in the world, whether it's from child labor to trading of human beings, or, you know, all these evils that we know about, that we're aware of. And Meister's question is, well, what, you know, what do we do about this? And he will say, look, you know, imagine your balls, your most beautiful and elegant soirees. The setting of the conversations is in St. Petersburg. Says, imagine your most sophisticated balls, where the food on the table is, you know, constituted by the carcasses of animals who've been killed. Your ladies, their dresses are made up with these whale bones, and so it's this, all of what looks beautiful and civilized is grounded in this history of violence. It's not, of course, it sounds at times proto-Nietzschean. It isn't, because Maestro wants to emphasize what he calls la loi d'amour, or the law of love, which, as a Christian, he thinks is the fundamental reality. But he thinks we don't get to appreciate that fundamental law of love until we first of all appreciate the level of cruelty and violence in the world. And of course, he links that to sin and to the fall. Mm-hmm. Now, quite how far I'd want to go along with Maestro, that's another matter. But he is certainly a powerful thinker, and I think a serious critic of any glib utilitarianism.
Right.
So I think any serious ethics has to take a particular anthropology seriously, has to take the facts the facts that we encounter seriously, and those are not always very cheering.